Getting started. First, search for Code 2. Play on your search engine and log in. Create a new project and name it as RC Car. List Picker for mobile connection. We are controlling the car by mobile. You'll need a list picker to select the device you want to connect to. After adding the list picker, go to its properties and rename it to Connect. Notifier for connection status. Add a notifier to display messages about whether your device is connected to the car or not. This is a non-visible component, means users won't see it, but it works in the background and only developers can see it. Adding control buttons. You'll need 4 buttons for controlling the car's movements: left, right, forward, and backward. You can find buttons in the user interface section. Drag and drop 4 buttons, then go to the components section and rename them appropriately: left, right, forward, and backward. Organizing the layout. To keep the interface neat, go to the Layout section. Add a table arrangement so you can arrange the buttons, e.g., forward at the bottom left, backward at the bottom right, left on the left side, and right on the right side. Adding motors. To move the car, you'll use motors. Go to the QTPI Mega Blocks section, drag and drop 2 motors, and rename them as left motor and right motor in the components section. Bluetooth client. A Bluetooth client is needed to connect the car to your mobile device. You'll find this in the connectivity section. This will handle the communication between your mobile device and the car. Completing the design. Now that you've added all the necessary components, list picker, notifier, buttons, motors, and Bluetooth client, the design part of your RC car project is complete. Thanks for watching. The next part will on the block section, where you'll program the buttons and motors to make the car move.